Hey folks, Rob Ager here. A short film review of Dragged Across Concrete, which came out last year and stars Mel Gibson and Vince Vaughn, and is written and directed by S. Craig Zahle, I think his name is, who is one of my favourite filmmakers at the moment. I've just discovered his work recently. He's very, very good. Dragged Across Concrete is the third movie by S. Craig Zahle. I am planning on doing a separate video on his previous movie, which was Brawl in Cell Block 99, which is a pretty brutal and vicious but quite intelligent prison drama. Dragged Across Concrete is a longer, slower film, but it's pretty brutal as well. It's a crime drama about cops and, well, it's about both sides of the law, really. You know, Vince Vaughn and Mel Gibson play a couple of cops who are a bit down on the luck. They've got suspended from the police force because they arrested some guy in a drug bust and they roughed the guy up a little bit and it was caught on camera. So you've got social media themes automatically come into play at the beginning of this film. But also the film shows the other side of the law, which is a black character. I can't remember his name, but basically he's an intelligent guy. And he's just trying to do good by his family. He needs money, and so he's in the crime world to look after his family. So yeah, the film basically revolves around these two sides of the law and order issue. I was very, very impressed with this film, really enjoyed it for a whole bunch of reasons, and I highly recommend that you go and see it if you haven't seen it already. And that's, I've not really heard anything about this movie since it came out. I've not seen it advertised. Hardly anybody has mentioned it to me. I saw Brawl in Cell Block 99 based on someone's recommendation a week or two ago. And on the basis of that, I went and looked up the same filmmaker and discovered this movie, Dragged Across Concrete. So the very fact that the film is so good and yet I've not been hearing about it anywhere, that was a good reason for me to do this review and give the film a little bit of promotion. So I don't want to give too much away about the plot because there's a lot of really good twists and turns in this film, and you know, I don't want to spoil it for you. I went in cold, watched the film not having any idea what the plot was about. I knew that Mel Gibson was in it and that was it. And Gibson is great in this, by the way, you know, as he usually is, even in his, as he's getting older, you know, what is he now? He must be 60, maybe older. And he's still cracking out some great movies. So, you know, whether you like the guy as a general person or not, whether you think he's a repulsive individual, I don't. I think he's just made some stupid mistakes, but I think he's basically an okay guy. But yeah, he's still cracking out the great movies. And Dragged Across Concrete is good for a whole bunch of reasons. One really strong aspect of it is that the film handles race relations in a very balanced and intelligent way. You know, a lot of people complain about modern Hollywood movies being sort of too politically correct. And when they handle political issues and racial issues, a lot of Hollywood movies paint a one-sided picture. But this movie doesn't. This movie shows in its characters and its narrative that racism comes from all sides. You know, it's not just a one-sided affair, and it does a good job of that. Like I said, it handles social media pretty well. But it also handles the the law and order issue really cleverly as well, because the two central characters, Mel Gibson's character and the guy who's on the other side of the law, the black guy who's introduced at the beginning of the film, those two guys, their situations and their story sort of mirror each other as the film goes on. I'm probably telling you a bit too much there, and I would rather not tell you too much about it. But yeah, very good, well thought out characters. The motivations of the characters make sense in this film. There's something that bothers me about a hell of a lot of movies when characters do things and you think, that's stupid. A person in that situation wouldn't do that. Why is this character a genius one minute and an idiot the next, and all that kind of stuff? This movie is really good in terms of character motivations. What the characters do from one scene to the next makes sense. You might not agree with what they do, but you understand why that character would do it. So that's good script writing from S. Craig Zahler. And also the plot points, I think, are really good as well. You know, a lot of movies be very predictable plot points. I mean, I hate it when a movie has a load of unpredictable stuff in the first half and then it just veers off into predictability in the second half, you know, as they veer towards a standard Hollywood ending. This movie doesn't do that. This movie kept me guessing all the way through, right up to the very end. I wasn't certain of what was going to happen. There was one or two moments where I thought, oh, this is going to happen, and it did happen, but not in a bad way, you know. So there's plenty of unpredictability in this. And the situations are complex enough because it's not just about any particular character's point of view. There's often three or four characters involved in a particular scene who each have their own complex perceptions of the situation. And so that makes it harder to predict again because there's so many different ways of thinking about each scene. And that also relates to a very, very important issue with this film, is that it doesn't spoon feed you a moral interpretation of the story. You know, so many movies get really preachy. Here's the good guys, here's the bad guys. They're really bad and you need to hate them. And everything this character does, it's because this character is pure. And watch the good guy beat the bad guy at the end. Yawn, yawn, yawn. This movie doesn't do that. Each character has got good and bad things going on for them. Well, most of them do anyway. I think there's one character or one or two characters in this who are really, really bad to the point of like, whoa, whoa, stay away from them. But most of the characters in this story have got good and bad things going on in terms of their morality. And the situations that are presented, it's not always clear cut in this story what is the right thing to do. A lot of the time it's very difficult. You're stuck between two choices where there's good and bad moralistic elements to either path that you choose to take. There's a lot of situations like that in this movie. And I think that makes it really good. Rewatch value is good. I watched it again last night and found myself interpreting some of the scenes a bit differently. You know, oh, maybe this character didn't consider this, or I can understand why they did that because of this factor. So yeah, it doesn't give easy moralistic answers, and that's great because real life is like that. It's not very often in real life that everything just fits into black and white good guys and bad guys. A lot of the time, there are multiple issues from both sides that complicate things. That's life, and this film reflects that. So yeah, folks, just go and check out Dragged Across Concrete. I haven't given much away about the details of the film because I don't want to spoil it, but I wanted to give it some promotion because I've not been hearing so much about it. Check it out. It's one of the best films of last year. Still, my favourite movie of 2018 is Hereditary, and I would possibly call this one my second favourite of 2018. You've been listening to Rob Ager. Bye for now.